Hey there, Fang Army, how are you all doing again? Welcome back to the FAANGPath YouTube channel. We are here again with another video on how you can set up your LinkedIn profile. Let's understand all the sections, why they're important, what to write in each section, and how it can make an impact. Let's set your profile up on the biggest professional network of the world. Before we get started, do not forget to subscribe, like, share, and comment on this video. And let other people know about FAANGPath if this helps you. All the best, let's get going. Step one, let's understand all the profile sections one by one. So I'll keep switching between my own profile and Nikita's profile to show you what are the differences like when you're making your own profile versus how people see it. It just gives you a little bit of differentiation on how your profile is seen versus how you see it when you're making it. So let's get started from the top. We'll take a top-down-bottom approach and top-to-bottom approach, I'm so sorry, and cover all the sections that are important to you, okay? So the first section is here, it is your cover image or banner image, like people like to call it. This should be a very basic idea of who you are. It gives details about what tools you could use, so let's go over mine. These are all my socials that people can connect me on. These are all the tools and technologies that I know of. I work with Siemens Energy, and the hashtag here means that I want people to associate me with an hashtag called Automate Energy because I'm an automation developer. And I also mentor with FAANGPath. So everything about me is in the crux of this little banner here. And for Nikita, she wants to talk about FAANGPath and let everyone know she is an amazing founder of a company called FAANGPath, so that's what her banner image talks about. Whatever you want people to know about you, just put it there. Second, your profile picture. It's usually good to have a picture which shows your face very clearly. Avoid caps, hats, all of those things, especially masks in these days. Click a picture and then wear your mask again. Next, put on name, and having this audio recording is a very good way, especially because we all have gone global. We're working from different places and somebody from a different country might not know how to pronounce your name. It's an easy way of knowing how to say somebody else's name. So a good thing to do this. The next would be your title or job description. This description is really important. It goes with you every single place. When you comment on somebody's profile after your name, a few characters of your description are shown everywhere. So be careful of what you write. Then the next is your location and the number of connections you have. It usually shows the number till 500. Not usually, it shows the number till 500 and then it just says 500 plus. Similarly, if you look at Nikita's profile, the name, this location is up. She has the content creator mode on. I will show you how to turn it on or off. And hence, you also see some hashtags for her, location, number of followers and connections, and much more. Okay, now you can start adding sections to your profile. The core basic details are already filled out. You can add an education. You can add an education, a work position, and different skills that you have. The next is the recommendations. You can add a few of your posts on the featured section. We'll come to it where it is and what how it helps. The licenses and certifications, if you have any courses you've completed, and ask people to write you recommendations. So this is that. In addition, you might want to add your volunteer experience, publications, patents if you have any, and all your projects. So that's how you add a section to your profile. Let's go down. This is what I was talking about, the creator mode. This analytics that you see here is about your own profile. How many views did your current video post have and all of those things. But when you scroll for Nikita, which is somebody else's profile, you wouldn't really see that. The next thing would be turning this creator mode on and a few more resources about your own profile. Step two, let's move forward. This is the summary section or the about section. Fill it out with a little story about yourself. talk about your skills, soft skills, hard skills, how people can reach out to you, and all those details. Here, if you see, Nikita also has an about section, and you can see the entire part of it. Then this is the featured section. So when you're actively creating content and you're posting a lot of things on LinkedIn on your profile, you can add them here on the featured section. This just gives a very simple way of people to look at your profile at a glance. Maybe you could add a few of your recent accomplishments, some big things about yourself, anything that is worth mentioning for people to look at before they go and jump into your activity section and find all the posts that you've made. Next, you move on to the activity section where you see different activities that you've done, the last recent activities in a glance, and rest all can be done through see all activity. And it takes you to a new LinkedIn page where all your activities can be seen, your likes, comments, everything under all activity, and everything that you have created as a post under posts. If you've written any articles, it goes under articles. If you've shared documents, it goes under documents. Okay, let's move forward. Now you start adding your experiences, the role that you're holding, the company, the duration. Try making it as correct as possible and synchronized with your resume. Usually when people see your resume, jump onto your LinkedIn, and if they see a difference between what your resume looks like versus what your LinkedIn looks like and what it talks about your experiences, there is a lot of apprehension if it is not matching. So try to keep them same. If you're being honest, it will always be the same. So do not lie. That's what I'm trying to say. Put in all the details about where you're working and everything. Put in a little detail of what you did there, and that's about your experience section. There is a bunch of things that you can do. Here is Nikita's, here is mine. Everything is added in here. Next, you go to the education section. You put in all the education details. What did you do there? What subject you studied, when, from when to when, and all of those things. You can also add volunteer experience like I showed you from the top in the add section option. If I see here back on my profile, add profile section, additional, and add volunteer experience. So from here you can add different volunteering experiences if you worked with some NGOs or anything where you worked as a volunteer. Some of your licenses or certifications, people tend to have a few certifications, so you can add them here. Adding your skills is very important. That helps recruiters find the right skill set that people need to have. Avoid it adding only two or three. Add all the skills that you have. I'm not saying lie, but add all the skills that you have. And recommendations. Ask people to write recommendations for you that you worked with. That could be your colleague, that could be a senior, that could be people who mentored you during your internship, people you worked with on a project. All those people can write you recommendations. Having recommendations gives some power to your LinkedIn profile as a whole. After recommendations, step 3, write about your projects. If you worked on different projects, feel free to add them. And if they were group projects, do add other creators as well. It gives your project power of what you did, who you did it with, and you're not really lying that you made it yourself. Then maybe if you know different languages, you can add that. If you work associated with different organizations, I used my clubs, but you could add anything that you see worth mentioning. Then the causes that you support, and then shows your interests. So people that you follow, people that you like, follow, you companies that you follow, so all different people, influencers, companies, different groups that you follow, and different schools or educational institutes that you follow. That's a little about how to set up your LinkedIn profile. I hope this video helps you out and you're able to set up your LinkedIn profile soon enough. Don't forget to find FAANGPath on LinkedIn. The link again is in the description box below. You can find me and Nikita as well to get a little bit of hint on how to write your profile, again in the description box below. If you find any more questions, if you have some doubts, feel free to reach out to us on all our socials. Again, the description box has all the links, as well as we have a Discord community of all the mentors and people like you who are looking for jobs or maybe a switch. Go ahead, connect with us on Discord and all our socials, and wait for another video. Until then, like and share this video if you find it useful, and we'll see you soon in another helpful video. All the best from the FAANGPath team. See you soon, everyone.